time to look at the most important OOPS concept, inheritance. So here I'm thinking about what example can I give you. So a simple pen here, and I don't really know what exactly I'm going to do with this pen. But I thought about it. This is actually a very good example of actually talking about the inheritance. As you can see that this is actually a simple correction pen. So correction pens are nothing but it's going to give out a white ink that's going to go on top of a paper, and this ink is going to be actually correcting your mistakes on the paper. But what exactly are these made of? These pens have a lot of different attributes which are very much similar to a normal pen that you write. You have a ballpoint pen, you have an ink pen, and you have a simple correction pen as well. What do they all these have in common? They have a simple structure to them. They have a body, which is nothing but that you're holding. They have a cap on that, so that's going to be obviously available for all your pens. And inside them, they have different varieties of things. Like one would have a simple tube holding the ink for you. One would have a simple tube actually where you have to refill your ink completely. And ones like this, which are actually completely sealed so that you can open that or see that. So these are different ways of how a pen is made. But one thing is very, very common, that is that the structure and the cap are very much similar everywhere. These are inherited from the basic structures, and the pens are actually going to give different use for you. So that's how simple inheritance is with respect to programming languages as well. Programming languages are great in actually inheriting concepts. They have different ways of inheriting things from multiple different places, and that's very much useful when you're actually playing with your classes. We learned about classes, right? So what if you want one class definition to be available for another class? It's going to be really, really costly in redefining entire thing right from scratch for just use of creating another class. So what you would do instead is that you inherit the concepts or inherit the variables or methods that are available in one class into another class, and that way it would make it really, really easy for us to go ahead and define things for us. So I'm going to be talking about that in depth, as well as make it a little bit of a breeze through the slides here. I don't want to take so much time in talking about inheritance, because even though it's very important, it's easy to understand. So that's what we're going to be doing through the slides in Dart specifically. Let me meet you towards the end of this video and summarize it for you in one place. Let's begin.
All right. So inheritance in Dart is probably one of the most important concepts that you will learn in any OOPS programming language. So with respect to Dart, again, the idea is that you are going to inherit some data attributes from one class to the another. How do you do that? It's very simple. Again, like in the right example I've shown you, there's a sample class which is called a sample class A, and we will have a sample class B as well. Now, like I've put, there's a simple notation that I've given, which is nothing but an arrow mark. We're going to be replacing that with the next concept or the next keyword, which is the extends keyword. What exactly happens is that, like I've given the example again, sample class A has a variable called X, and it has its own constructor again, and there's a sample class B, which is now extending the value or the concept or the data attributes of sample class A. Now, what will sample class B have? Sample class B will have access to variable X, and it will also have additionally the variable Y with itself. So that's the simple idea of extending or inheriting the data from one class to another. Let's go back to Dart pad here. For example, I've written the sample class for understanding purpose here. Just do the sample and create another class called a sample. Maybe inherited class B, and we're going to be extending sample class, and we're going to say awesome. So I've created the two classes for us here. So what I've done is I've created as inherited class B. Now it's extending the class A, so which is nothing but our num variable num x, and num x is going to be accessible through our inherited class B also. So what we're going to do is now just create a simple object for this here. We will say that variable s is equal to inherited class B of, and we can now access the value. For example, let's say the value of this is 10 here, and the value of this is equal to 20 here. Now what you can do is you can directly access the value of X through the object of inherited class, so that's going to be X. Now when you print this, it's going to say 10, which is the value from here, but we didn't even have any reference to that in the while main section here. We're directly going to call the inherited class, which will now have the variable X also as part of that, because we have inherited the all the data. You could even create your own methods here. You could say get something like print inside super class, or maybe parent. you could say print inside the parent class. And now when you do this, you have access to the methods as well. So you'd say that crap, you can even print the values from your parent class as well. The most basic understanding or most basic example that everybody gives is that assume that there is going to be a parent and the parent is going to have a child. So what exactly do you think happens? The child inherits all the qualities or the attributes of the parent. We have similar set of slang with respect to classes as well. So parent class is nothing but the class which has the basic attributes. The child will like additionally have their own attributes, but they will also have access to their parent class attributes. So parent and child is going to be how we're going to be defining our inherited classes. All right, now that we've seen about the extents, what next? So what if you want to call a method that is actually present as part of the parent class? Now you can do that using the super method. So super methods will give you access to methods that are actually part of the parent class itself. Now let's go back to the example here. We have a parent which is nothing but the print inside parent. What if you want to create your own method here, like say let's say print inside class B or something like that, and you want to call this method. How do you do that? You could directly call the super is the keyword, and just say print inside parent. So as soon as you put that, it's going to say that for us, right? It's going to complete it for you. So what is happening is that you're seeing that super, which is nothing but the super class of. The super class is another slang wherein we are referencing to the class that is being inherited. The class that is being inherited here is the sample class. So the super obviously refers to this, and you're going to say print inside parent, which will come here and print this one here. Now we can now create a simple variable for this, which is nothing but a B, and we'll say print when you print this, it's going to directly do the same thing again. That's because we've come here and we're calling this, and we are printing this. We could do something like this here. I don't know. Now it will print inside class B followed by print inside class parent. So that's the use of your super method or the super keyword, which will refer to your super class or the base class or your parent class, however you want to call it. All right, so now that you understood how do you do the super method, now you also understood how you access your parent methods, what is next? The next is actually nothing but a simple override, which is a simple annotation, like you call it in Dart, that is going to say that there is a method that is going to clash in both the parent as well as the child. So let's go back to a Dart pad. I'll tell you that in detail. Now let's say that we have a method like this. Let's say that method is going to be clash method. Clash method is going to be the method. Now I'm going to say this is a sample class method. Now what if we have another this method, same method in our child as well? Now let's do this. This brings us to the next concept called as overriding, which is when there is going to be some variables or data attributes that are part of this base class that is also being re-referenced or re-written differently in our child class. When you want to do that, just do a simple override. This simple annotation will take care of saying that if there is going to be a method that has the same definition, like your why, your method name, followed by the arguments as well, everything has to match. If that is a scenario like that, just replace that method with the definition of the child method. So I'm going to say this is inside the child method or child class B method. So when I'm going to call this here, it's directly going to go here and take this value only and not consider this. So just run it here. You see, it's saying that inside the child class B method. Let's remove this. But it does not change, right? So one important thing here is that it's not going to affect that much, but because the concept of overriding is going to happen no matter what, but it's going to be really, really helpful for people to understand or additionally see and maintain the code that there is going to be a definite way of overriding that is going to happen. It's not going to change that the methods are going to be overridden here or not. By default, if the signatures match, signatures here are nothing but your return type followed by method name and your argument as well. If all of that match both places, it's by default going to take this one only, or whichever is actually going to be the child class only. It's completely going to ignore the parent method, but if it's going to be additionally helpful if you put your add override, which is a simple annotation to let the people know, or let the even data SDK itself know, that there is going to be definite overriding that's going to happen. So that's going to be the concept of overriding when you are actually looking at inheritance in Dart. So alright, that's it for this video. We learned about how do you inherit classes in Dart using the extends keyword, followed by the super, and also the concept of overriding, which is important in Dart inheritance. That's it for this video. Let's go in and summarize and come to close this video out.
Alright, we did look at the most important concept of inheritance in Dart. I will take you through the three important concepts, which is the extends keyword, followed by the super keyword, and also what is the overriding do in Dart using the add override annotations, all of that. So if this video is informative, you know what to do, drop that like and also subscribe. Let me meet you in the next video. We're going to be talking about a little bit complex stuff from here on, talking about more about inheritance and how do you do different type of classes, because those are very, very important and these play a very important role in creating a complete program in your application. So that's what we're going to be doing. Make sure you stay tuned. Let me meet you there. Until then, peace out.